My talking habit has, I think, been around ever since I was in my mother's womb. And gurgled around there for 9 months, and probably gave the loudest cry upon coming out. And honestly, haven't stopped crying ever since then. After I saw what the world actually had to offer. But it was this absolute need to get my voice across that defined me very early on, and earned me the name in popular circles as the radio. Now the radio very quickly decided what she one day wanted to be, the product of a very patriotic father and a determined mother. Needless to say, that dream of mine being in the army didn't last very long, as I grew older and conformed to what was considered more normal for a girl my age. The color pink, Barbies, and God forbid, boys. Now very early on, the words justice and country were emulated in pictures such as these for me. But while the 90s soon wore off, the sense of justice that had been imbibed in me only grew. And so here I stand at 16, dreaming of being a lawyer one day. But why is it relevant? Why am I wasting your time? You could clearly go have a good discussion about law, justice, and order with some of those Harvard graduates that occupy top-notch positions of law firms. I haven't revolutionized the judicial process of any single country, and have hardly done the steps of Harvard. So why am I wasting your time? Because to be concerned about fairness, justice, and liberty are not ideals limited to the laps of those who occupy top-notch positions in law firms. The spirit of these grow in the laps of those who choose to let them grow. Now, a little bit of background information about myself. I'm from Delhi, capital of India and rape capital of the world. Where no female, from my 11-year-old sister to my 75-year-old grandmother, is safe from the prying eyes of men who undress you the minute you set out from home. The fear of theft, of murder, and of rape pollute the air that is already thick with the smog of my city. So what does a common woman like me do? We promise our mothers we'll be home by 8, we'll come with a guy, and of course, we'll cover any bare scrap of visible skin that could possibly arouse a man. Because you see, eve teasing and catcalling haven't really been ratified into the law yet, and so we are the victims, but we are also those to blame because you are dressing wrong and bringing it onto yourself. But this is where we are going to start the fight. Because where the justice system fails is where we begin our own battle. Where laws bend in the favor of the rich or of the majority, and where the judicial process is decaying, is where we stand as our own advocates. Now the traditionalists may argue with a single word, anarchy. What if, in this form of establishment of law, where we define what is morally right, we form our own type of lawlessness? Wouldn't that lead to chaos? Well, from the way I see it, our collection of stringent and positive rules that we define as laws are hardly doing us any good at this point in time anyway. Every great constitution proclaims the ideals of democracy, liberty, equality, and yet this spirit of racism and gender differences still exists in these great societies. We breathe the air of injustice and failure while we proclaim ourselves to be the most developed species on the planet. Now a little bit of real world application. I want to have a look at these photos. This particular law or series of laws that I find to be very peculiar. A fine for feeding a stray animal, or the charge of theft for a poor man who's stealing medicines to feed, to give to his ailing mother, or just stealing a loaf of bread to feed his children that would otherwise die of starvation, as is the case in most third world countries. But the letter of our law states, no, it's a crime. It's wrong. We can deny the person the right to a meal, but we can't allow ourselves to be corrupted. But isn't that going against our own moral code? Especially for someone like me who has a deep amount of sympathy for animals and even for poor people, I can't let them starve. For me, if I see a crying cat, I will go outside and feed it. It goes against what I believe is my spirit of the law, what I believe is morally and ethically right for me to do. It's incorrect to deny any organism, especially a human being of our very own species, the right to a meal. And we crave that intensity and chaos, knowing that what we are doing goes against the law, but we have a good sleep, guilt-free. our own code of ethics. And so what do? I go out every night, and I feed that crying white cat anyway. Because at the end of the day, who do I have to please? Myself. And I go home and I have a very nice sleep, knowing that what I've done is right. It is conscientiously wrong for ourselves to deny anyone the right to a meal or the right to life that is promised by the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, even. To conclude, I just want to leave you with a bit of an analogy. The mosquito is a relatively insensible, simple being who feeds on the delicacy of human blood for the 28 days that is his lifespan. And yet, does not discriminate. Whether A positive blood is better or B negative, whatever, it takes it as it is. And yet, this simple creature is not smart enough to discriminate. But how can we, who pride ourselves on being the only species to have ever conquered the moon, stupid enough to allow ourselves to be divided amongst ourselves on the basis of laws that are scratched on parchment based on archaic notions to see law justice?